LoveLine is meant for an adult audience. LoveLine may contain sexually oriented content. Listener discretion is advised.
Adam Carolla, Dr. Drew.
I'm not modeling anymore for the two of you.
LoveLine.
Yes, it's the LoveLine. I'm Adam Carolla. It is Dr. Drew over there. Phone number 1-800-LOVE-191. Fax number 310-854-4455. Dr. Drew is a board-certified physician and addiction medicine specialist. Tonight, our guest from City of Angels, Hill Harper, sir, in studio tonight. That was very smooth, wasn't it?
Really, it sounded like you've never been away.
Wednesday nights, 8 o'clock on CBS. And, Drew, you'd be interested in this show because it has to do with hospitals.
Oh, except those frustrate me.
Really?
Those drive me crazy.
Why is
because
that?
All the doctors are better looking than you?
That, and it's just so untrue. It's except ER, which is like borders untrue.
I don't know. I think you should check out our show.
I will. I've got to.
We've got a couple doctors on staff that are there all the time, and we try to stick as real as possible.
My interpretation is the medical end of it is getting more and more accurate.
Yes.
It's just the attitude is different.
The personal part, yeah.
Listen, I've been to the hospital a few times. People don't run around that much. There's a lot of sitting around.
It's the concerns of running a hospital are so egregious where you can't get people to, like, take a patient downstairs for an x-ray and stuff. And those are the problems with practicing medicine today, and none of that ever gets on television.
No, but that's boring.
We're trying to get into those issues since it's an inner city hospital on the show. So we're trying to get into the issues of underfunding and the care issues and people not receiving proper medical care and all that stuff.
That's it. Okay. I'm watching.
Wednesdays at 8, CBS.
Also, Hill is in The Skulls, which is coming. It's not out in theaters yet.
March 31st.
A ton of buzz about that.
Yeah. I've seen a lot of stuff on it, but I still don't know what it's about.
Well, there are a lot of guys in the movie that a lot of women want to sleep with. I think Josh Jackson from Dawson's Creek is high on the list, and Paul Walker, who was in She's All That and Varsity Blues.
Right.
And
it's about these guys get caught in like a parallel universe.
It is?
They sort of sell their soul to the devil, and right?
It's
How do you know, Drew?
I've seen the trailer.
I think the one-line version is The Firm at Yale. That's it. The Firm at Yale.
And speaking of Yale, you went to Brown, didn't you?
Yeah, and Harvard for grad school.
Wow.
Yeah.
Magna cum laude, that's, or laude, as I like to say. That's, I don't know what it means, but I know it's good. You got to be smart to get that. What is it, the magna and the summa? And
the summa.
Cum, magna, and summa.
Yes, cum, summa. No, sum.
Cum,
no,
magna.
Cum, magna.
So.
Summa.
So assume as high as you
most.
Go?
Yeah, that's the most.
But nobody ever seems to get that.
Somebody gets that. You just never meet them.
Yeah,
they come on a radio
show. They're in the library.
They hang around. But magna is what you usually hear about the most, right?
Yeah.
Cum.
Yeah.
You hear about cum most.
Yeah, okay. Well, here's, but you got cum here. You got magna cum laude.
Yeah, but the magna's not there if they're in the first run.
Okay, so you could be cum laude.
Yes.
Or you could be magna cum laude.
Yes.
Or you could be sum magna cum laude.
Summa cum laude.
All right. And they don't have that at Valley College.
No, Valley College, I don't think that's it.
Wow.
Different schools, it means different things at different schools, too.
And Brown is an Ivy League school, but, you know, I got to tell you, I don't know how many people know it. I mean, I know the people who go to Brown know.
No, wait a minute.
None of my friends know.
None of your friends.
You got to go to Harvard or Princeton or
Brown,
Yale.
Particularly in like late 80s, early 90s, was probably the most popular school in the country for higher education.
Well, you know, John F. Kennedy Jr. went
there. Yeah.
He left there before I got there, but he was there. Amy Carter went there.
It was sort of what Stanford's doing now. Really,
it was
the same idea.
Klaus Von Bülow's daughter went there before the unfortunate insulin incident.
Yeah, with his wife. And did you...
maybe that was after.
Did you say you went to Harvard after that?
Yeah, that was for grad school, though.
What'd you major in?
I got a joint degree in law and public policy from the Kennedy School of Government.
That's
wow. You're much too smart for either this show or acting or this city.
How many is going to own this city in a couple of years?
All right, we will take some calls.
Did you practice for a while or anything?
Never practiced law. Never took the bar. Law is probably, I apologize to all the lawyers out there, probably the most boring profession I could ever imagine in my life.
Yeah.
You got the degree and that was it?
Yeah.
And did you always know you'll be an actor? Or?
I knew it, an artist was in me. I didn't know what type of art I was going to express.
Do you use your knowledge base right now? I mean, are you planning a way that can be put to use?
I mean, I don't use it in a traditional way, but yeah. I think you use any kind of knowledge you ever receive in whatever ways on, you know, subconscious levels.
It never goes away.
Yeah. I mean, Adam talks about how he uses his knowledge sexually that has nothing to do with it. I mean,
well, it's not even his life experience or knowledge at all, even for that matter.
It's all theory,
yeah.
But I still put it into place. Paul.
Is it a technical thing or is he there?
I'm right here.
There you are.
Yeah.
Will you answer then, Paul, please?
Yeah.
You're 24. What's up?
Not much. I don't know if it's my medication lithium or what it is, but it seems like during masturbation, it's like I almost overheat to the point where I have to stop. Like I just get too hot.
Yeah. And do you do it during other activities that are vigorous?
Sometimes I do it too. I don't know if it's a chemical change or what. But
are you on something other than lithium?
No, that's pretty much it.
Well, the pretty much part. What's the other thing?
The other one's like Seroquel, but I just started that one.
All right, well, that can do it.
Really?
Absolutely.
You overheat when you're masturbating?
Seroquel can change your vascular tone. It can change the way you orgasmic function. It can change a lot.
Or even like just at night, just trying to sleep too. I overheat during the night, and I almost have to crack the windows during the winter because that's why I like the winter the best. So
interestingly, the medicines like Seroquel usually make people cold.
Yeah.
Cold intolerant rather than hot. But it can change all that. So you ought to talk to your doctor about it.
You also should think about tweaking your technique a little bit if you're overheating when you're masturbating.
He's working too hard.
That's right. It's too much friction.
Does it change the color of your skin?
Maybe a little bit.
Only dark-skinned people get that change. He's talking to you. Really irritated skin. It will pigment or depigment.
Really? Yeah. Patches on my face.
Yeah.
Just kind of get.
Yeah, but white guys get all red and blotchy.
But they don't pigment usually. They can. They can. It's really bad.
Before though.
All right, Paul. Well, look at. Listen. You do what I do. You masturbate in the shower.
Yeah.
All right. Keep that cold water running on you.
I've tried that.
He'll pass out.
That kind of throws things off too.
It does. You got to put some of those non-skid strips down on the bottom of the tub, or you could be in a world of hurt.
Yeah. Because
Let me tell you. Let me give you guys a hint. The shower curtain, not a handle. Now you'll take the whole goddamn thing down with you. That's where they'll find you. Big puddle of semen wrapped up in a shower curtain, hit the head. You know, the police chief's in there talking to your parents. Well, we, for the best we can put together, Miss Carolla, your son was masturbating probably for the fifth or sixth time that evening. Looks like he got a calf cramp, locked up his left leg, went for the curtain. Curtain came down because he put it up.
And he finished.
And hit his head on the side of the bowl, and that's where we found him. It's been 5 days. Oh. It won't be an open casket. Lynn?
Yeah?
That's my ultimate fear, really, is to be found, you know, somewhere. Right.
Well, you're going to set that service up, aren't you?
Oh, yeah. Yeah. Well, we did it last year on The Man Show, but I really mean this. I want to start a series, a service, Hill.
Mm-hmm.
There's a lot of guys, like, where are you from originally?
I was born in Iowa, and then I grew up mostly in the Bay Area, San Francisco.
Okay, so your parents, you're living out here in Southern California, right?
Right, right.
And your
right.
parents, your family, somewhere else.
Right.
And God forbid something should happen to you, your parents are going to have to come into town and, you know, collect your belongings.
Yeah.
You know, they're going to go into your house, your apartment, your condo, and they're going to find the porn magazines. They're going to find the whips, the chains, the vibrators, the handcuffs.
Edible panties.
Everything. Yeah. It's all going to be there. And they're going to... Your mom's going to... Your mom, who's already grieving, this is just going to do her in when she sees all of this. Yeah. God, not to mention the, you know, 6-foot novelty bong and the rest of the nonsense you have hanging around your apartment.
But I'm dead already, so why do I care?
That you care. Is it planning?
I'm planning ahead for you.
Okay.
What I'm
okay.
saying, yes, hypothetically, you're dead.
Right.
But what I'm saying is a lot of guys are in this situation, especially living in the L.A. area. The parents are from somewhere else. They're going to come in and see what's in their apartment. I had this service where you sign up, a little pager goes off when you kick the bucket. We get to the apartment before the folks do. Clean out the entire place. All the porn, all the bongs, the paraphernalia, whatever it is you got in there.
Get the potpourri out.
That Asian hooker you've had chained to the radiator for
right.
all those years. The whole thing, we replace it with, you know, picture of mom and dad, Jesus, put a Bible down, a basket of potpourri.
That's beautiful. That's kind of like paying for your gravesite before you kick the bucket. It's almost like a mental insurance policy.
It's an insurance.
Yeah. Right. Yeah. You rest easy. Yeah.
That's a great idea.
Yeah, it is. It's solid. Lynn?
Yeah.
Yeah, fear takes most parents coming out from the East Coast or whatever a couple days to get out. We get there before they do. All we need is a master key. And we sell the pornography and give the proceeds to the needy the way you would have wanted it. I probably could have a museum or school built once they sell the porn in my house.
What are you talking about?
Yeah. I'm talking about a college. I'm about a four-year four-year college.
Yeah.
Lynn?
Yeah?
You're 23. What's up?
Well, me and my husband and my friends had a fivesome.
I could bet on her just her voice.
A fivesome?
Yeah.
All right. Is that three girls and two guys?
Yeah. It was me and my husband, a boyfriend and girlfriend, and a friend girl.
Female.
Right.
Yeah. And how did that work?
It worked out pretty good.
Yeah. Was everyone drunk or high or something?
We've been drinking wine.
All right. And what room were you in?
My bedroom.
And is everyone up on the bed when you do this?
Uh-huh.
It's a hell of a bed.
Who was the fifth person?
Just a female friend.
Yeah.
And everyone's naked, right?
Yeah.
Yeah. And you and your husband start off on each other, or you start off on someone else?
Well, it started out as me and my husband and the guy friend, and then he left and went and got the two girls.
Okay.
And then it was just me and my husband, and then everybody came in.
Oh, wait a minute. Just hold on there, Drew. I'm going to find out how else this worked. Then do you go over to the other guy at a certain point?
Well, we started on the girls.
Yeah. Well, all right. Did you have sex with the other guy?
Yeah.
You did?
Yeah.
Where was your husband?
He was next to me with the other girl.
Having sex with her?
The fifth girl had left.
The fifth girl had left.
Right,
All right, and you didn't have any feelings when your husband was on top of the girl that was next to you?
No. Me and my husband are kind of breaking up, I guess.
Oh, all right.
Before this happened, or as a result of this?
No, but way before this happened.
All right, so what the hell?
So,
do you have a long history of these sorts of endeavors?
The fifth girl and my husband and I, about a year ago, messed around.
Did that destabilize the relationship, or was it already in trouble?
Whatever you're trying to get at. And listen, it's good once you know the relationship's on the way out. It's like driving a rent-a-car at that point. You might as well just throw it in reverse while you're still rolling forward. Who cares? It's over.
You know,
go for broke. It's like when you know you're in a dream.
It just sounds to me, if you're a guy, I understand that's what the guy's doing that, but it just sounds to me that she's going to end up feeling humiliated and less worthwhile as a result of all this, I suspect.
Do you have any kids?
I don't have any problem with it. The boyfriend and girlfriend are having a hard time with the fact that me and him together.
Do you have any kids?
No.
Okay.
Good. All right. So you don't have any kids. It didn't work out. You had a little fivesome.
Well, why do I got a voice thing going on with her? Though?
She's obviously chaotic. Lynn?
Chaotic.
Lynn,
what do you call what you're describing?
Where's your dad?
He's in Chicago.
Yeah. All right. Good. Just where I want him. And do you like him?
Yeah, we get along fine.
You do. All right. He didn't abandon you or anything?
No. My parents are divorced. They got divorced when I was six.
Yeah.
And my dad got custody of me and my brother. Ooh. And we moved around a lot, and he was pretty strict with me. I didn't lose my virginity till I was like 17.
Yeah, but still, what mom must have been in bad shape to have...
When I was about 17 and a half, I moved in with my mom. I moved out with my dad's and moved in with my mom, and she feels bad for leaving us, so she pretty much let me do whatever I wanted.
And why did she leave?
Just because she couldn't deal with my dad.
What was Matthew's dad?
He's very possessive and controlling.
Yeah.
Now, wait a minute. Your mother gave up custody, or she was not granted custody?
The impression that I get from my dad, he always, would tell me things that my mom wouldn't let me live with her and everything, but...
All right.
There's something big missing here, but be that as it may.
Women get custody unless they're, drug addicts, usually.
Yeah, that's right.
No, they're neither one of them ever.
But, there's something awful going on with her. Something terrific going on with her, and be that as it may, this all is chaotic. I'm getting an awful feeling just listening to the story.
Yeah.
And why do people then go, "Oh, chaotic me"? Please.
Yeah. All right.
Please.
Hey, listen, when a mother gives up her children, and by the way, lets the kids be raised by a guy who they think is dangerous or irresponsible or abusive, something is horribly wrong with that mother.
Yeah.
It's usually they're chasing drugs and they're not interested, but if they're not high, then there's really something wrong. I even prefer they be junkies. You know what I mean? At least it gives them an out. It gives them an excuse.
We can understand it.
Yeah, it's like when I hear about a murder, if a guy went around and, you know, shot a guy and took his wallet, I'm like, all right. But if he just comes up behind his head and hits him with a hammer, I'm like, all right, now I'm frightened. I got to get a helmet. You know what I'm saying? Doesn't seem to be any motive there.
Yep.
Ray?
Yeah.
You're, what the hell? How old
Ray,
is he?
You got to smoke less pot.
18?
Oh, wow.
Drew, tilt that thing down so I can see what's going on.
What's up?
Thank you.
Well, every time I get like a session going on with my friends and we get a sack of weed and if it has seeds in it, they always de-seed it. And they always tell me that like I'm stupid because I don't care. I'll smoke the seeds if it's in it or not. I won't break it up.
You don't smoke anything, I bet.
Okay. Yeah, right. Listen, a turtleneck sweater falls in the bowl of the bong, you'll pop it.
But
someone shoots a duck and it lands in there, you'll pop that duck. Come on.
They said that if I smoke them, that I'll probably go impotent. So
no,
I didn't.
I don't know. I get that question asked about every month, and I don't know where that comes from. You'll get impotent from just smoking a lot of pot.
No, you can go blind from smoking seeds, though.
Yeah, that's what they used to say when I was a teenager.
Yeah, you know why? Because they explode while your face is stuffed down in front of a lighter and you take an eye out.
No, Ray, just a pot by itself can make you infertile, or have difficulty with fertility and difficulty with sexual function.
Good. All pluses in your life,
Ray. Are you smoking straight pot, Ray, or are you smoking the chronic?
Chronic when I can afford it.
How much more is chronic, Drew?
I have no idea.
Dale, how much?
Like a gram is like running about $15 with chronic.
Listen, I'm a little out of the pot loop, although I was getting stoned with a Snoop Dogg last week. I don't mind.
That was chronic.
That was definitely chronic.
That was chronic.
Oh, my God, I'm still stoned. That was last Tuesday, I swear to God. Chronic is just good weed, though, right?
It's laced. Yeah.
Oh, it's laced?
It's got a nice, good color. You don't get any seeds with it. It's just straight nuts.
All right. Hey, Ray?
Laced with what?
Well, different people have different definitions, but some people believe that the truest form of chronic is actually weed that's laced with PCP.
Yeah.
That's true chronic. Right. And then there's variations.
Things that are called chronic.
Right. Exactly.
Hey, Ray?
The original chronic.
Whatever your problem is, you have much bigger fish to fry. Than the seeds.
Yes.
You're a marijuana addict.
Severely.
You can hear it in your voice. And you're going to have a hard life ahead of you.
Uh-huh.
You got to cut out the weed, brother.
All right. Okay. I saw that new commercial that you're in.
Done and done.
What new commercial are you in?
This hot looking girl that walks by. She with a nice rack.
Yeah, that's her.
Yeah, she was hot. Yeah.
Ooh, I'm going to be in a commercial tomorrow.
You are?
What's her name? Doritos. Allie Landry.
Really?
DrDrew.com is putting out a bunch of commercials.
Oh, who cares? Oh, that's good. Cable. That's internet. No one cares.
Yeah, but it's going to be...
No, I'm doing a real commercial on TV.
No, ours is going to be on network TV, too.
Ray's great. I said, hey, Ray, you got a real problem with the marijuana. He's like, you got to quit smoking.
Yes, uh-huh. Yeah.
Okay. Anyways, watching a commercial and checking a huge rag, man. This is long. I'm glad I'm reaching the kids. Robert? Robert, hang up.
Son of a
bitch. Matt?
Yes.
What's up?
Hey, first off, I just want to say, I'm really happy about what you and Drew do. When I worked over at the Naval Hospital, it really showed, you know, a lot of the Marines and stuff listened to the show and valued your advice. I just want to say thanks a lot.
Thanks. Are you calling from Maryland?
I'm calling. I live right by Bethesda in D.C.
But now close your eyes for a second, Adam. How old is Matt? Just 28?
Yeah, he sounds old.
Yeah, and we've had 15-year-olds that sound 4.
You're 15?
Yes, sir.
Holy Christ. I thought you were much older than that.
I'm a very goal-oriented guy.
Yeah, I am too, except my goal is masturbating and napping.
Right. Well, you know, I got a lot.
But I'm still goal-oriented. I mean, why can't I call myself that?
I don't know. What are your goals, Adam?
Masturbating and napping.
That's very good. That you shouldn't have any problems then.
Well, I don't know. I'm out of the house a lot. It's tough.
You are the man there, Adam.
Thank you. All
that's
right.
Why
you
so have the man show, I think.
Thank you there. Yes, Matt. So, what do you have a question?
Yes, I do.
All right.
All right. The question is, this girl that I've known since I was in kindergarten, she's involved with this guy. Found out was abusing her, you know, like beating her around and stuff. So last week I walked over to his house and I knocked on the door and I'm like, come out. And so he walks out and I just kicked the S out of him.
Great.
And so now I got all these problems. Like I got a subpoena in the mail.
Uh-uh.
And I got, you know, my father's pissed off at me. The school's all like, we're going to suspend you.
Oh my gosh.
And
yeah, you've probably always been a good guy, huh?
I try, I guess. I don't know. I mean, I thought it was the right thing to do, you know. And my dad called my rabbi, you know. The rabbi's calling me, and he's all like, Matt, you know, chill out. And
rabbi's calling.
You know you're in trouble when the rabbi calls.
Wow.
That's right. No, I mean,
Matt, you should chill out with a nice cold soda.
What did you do to the guy?
I'm a little prone to these sort of things.
Jeez, you got to join the JDL. There's not too many scrappy Jews out there. They need them. They need guys like you. Let me tell you something about the Jews. Jews are either complete wussies or they're like trained assassins. They don't have the intermediate Jew.
No.
You know what I'm saying?
Hold on a second,
Matt. Quiet down. I'm explaining about the Jews. Like, you know, there's a lot of white guys, black guys, Asian guys. They're like normal in-between kind of guys. Yeah, they could kick a little ass. Maybe they could get their ass kicked. Jews, either pure puss... Or they were in the Israeli army for 15 years instructing a commando unit, and they'll kill you with piano wire.
Right, that's right.
They had no in-between Jews.
Yeah.
Trained assassin, nebbish wuss. Nothing in between. What is that? You know what it is? You know what the Asian equivalent to that is? The hairstyles and here's what I'm saying. With the Asians, they either have the real super... sort of traditional type of guys, a lot of bowing,
right.
Three-piece suits, you know, all that kind of stuff, or just the crazy kid with the spiked hair, the tattoos, and he's driving the Acura that's lowered down to the ground. He's going insane.
Yeah.
There's no in between culturally for the Asians, but that's a dress thing. That's not the ass kick thing. The Jews have the ass kick thing, and Matt, he's over on the commando. Israeli commando side,
Green Beret.
Yeah.
I just want to say something about me. I suppose I am on the Israeli commando side because of the fact I have Israeli cousins, and they're actually sending for me, and I might actually be an Israeli commando.
I know. Yeah. I told you. You tough Jews are in big demand.
Hey, man, here's what you got to do.
It's true. Did I call this?
Yes, you called it.
He's going to Israel to be a commando.
Before you make that big decision at 15.
They're over there in Israel going, we found a tough Jew in America. He's only 15. Let's train him and get him over here.
Go make amends, Matt. Make it good. I'm sure if you show remorse and do community service on it.
But, Drew, this bastard doesn't deserve remorse.
I understand that, but you can't ever take the laws into your own hands, and that's what you've done, and as such you've violated. And you, unless you want a whole lot of trouble, I agree. You can bring the guy to task somehow, and you should keep working that angle as you also make it right, because you've violated the law.
All right, he was scaring me. I'm glad he's going to Israel now. Hill Harper's our guest tonight. You can find him on City of Angels, which airs Wednesday nights 8:00 CBS. Also coming up in the debut of. I shouldn't say the debut, but the release of The Skulls, which is out March 31st.
March 31st.
Yes. We'll take ourselves a little break. When we come back, we'll speak to Nick. Nick's got the curve in his penis. Wants to know if it's from too much masturbation. We'll explain to him why he's so stupid after this.
We'll be right back with more.
This is Loveline on Outrageous Talk Radio, 100.7 The Buzz.
Loveline. I'm Adam Carolla. He is Dr. Drew. Phone number 1-800-LOVE-191. Tomorrow night, our good old friend Henry Rollins will be in here. Always an entertaining show.
Saw him at the Grammys. He's doing great.
Oh, you saw him at the Grammys?
Yeah.
What was he doing?
I don't know. Promoting something. His spoken word, I guess. Yeah.
Hill Harper's our guest tonight. He is in City of Angels, which is on Wednesday nights, 8 o'clock, CBS. Also coming out in the feature, The Skulls. What's your part in The Skulls, by the way?
Josh Jackson, who's the lead of The Skulls. He and I are roommates at Yale. We're both seniors. It's our last year. We're both on the crew team. And he gets tapped to join the secret society, this ultra-elite white, male, conservative, rich secret society called the Skulls.
I thought they were Republicans.
And, well, they are. You know, the actual Skull and Bones, which is a real secret society at Yale, George Bush was a former member, his son, George W. Bush. Huh. A lot of really... It's interesting. I think the last three or four people who ran the CIA were Skull and Bones at Yale.
And is this a science fiction type thing? I mean, does it...
Thriller. It's a thriller. Straight out thriller in
I thought
college.
They were getting to some kind of alternate universe or something, you were saying.
No. That's the Matrix.
They get stuck in this parallel society, like, that no one's allowed to get out of. They know something. They have to kill them to get out.
Okay? Oh, I like those.
Yeah.
Yeah, like where everything's good for a little while, then you realize
Nikita.
Things are evil and you can't get out.
Right.
Nice.
You get it in a little too deep.
Right.
Hey, I'm monitoring the chats again at drdrew.com. People want to distribute themselves across them. I'll be happy to take questions out of that. And I was just looking at it a few minutes ago. People want to hear the barf noise of David Allen Greer. That's the most popular question for the night.
Let's
see. There we go.
David Allen Greer was on the show.
Log on to drew.com and get in the chat rooms, and I'll get your questions.
He was on the show last week. I think I was talking about my anus, and he, can you do it again there, Anderson, or... That's too much radio for the kids. You know the part where David Allen Greer throws up that we were talking about? There we go.
That's pretty good.
Oh, Adam laughed so hard. I thought he was going to poop himself.
I almost wet myself, yeah. Nick, yeah, he did that, except for he did it for about 10 minutes straight.
My asshole's awesome. On fire.
Nick?
Yeah.
What's up? You're 16 years old. You have a curved penis.
Also, some requests for the boogie, which we haven't heard for a long time.
The Dr. Drew boogie?
Yeah.
All right. Well, we'll hear that later, too. Nick, your penis is curved.
Yeah.
And you suspect it's because of excessive masturbation.
Yeah.
How many times a day can we put you down for?
Well, it depends. Like, sometimes five.
Yeah, it always depends.
Yeah, maybe more times.
Right.
About five or six.
Five or six?
Yeah.
Okay. Doesn't depend on that much, does it?
Well, if I'm in a good mood, I'll do it a lot, but...
Yeah.
If I'm, like, not feeling that good...
Right. You do it, like, four times?
Yeah.
Right. Four. And other days when you're feeling extra generous, maybe six, seven?
Eight, yeah.
Yeah. That's solid.
Oh, boy.
Yeah, he's 16. That's healthy. A little lighter than I'd like to see for a 16-year-old lad, but
wow.
You're right on pace.
Were you? Let me just ask the obvious questions up front. Were you sexually abused when you were a little younger?
Listen, 16-year-old guys can do this.
I understand, but I'm trying to decide if this is a compulsion or if this is just him. And at 10 times a day, you're not having time for much else.
Well, he's only 5'6". Nick, are you 5'6" a day?
Yeah.
Are you 7-8 times a day?
Not today.
Not today?
No.
How many times today?
Five or six, yeah. I don't count, really. Like, about five, yeah.
All right.
Five.
All right. Yeah.
You sound sort of ashamed about it, for one thing.
Are you masturbating right now?
No.
He took a break.
I swear to God.
But you sound kind of ashamed of this, are you?
He's on the hand-strengthening ball now, and then he gets back to his penis.
Like, a whole bunch of people think it's real gross to masturbate, you know?
Who is that that thinks that?
Like, well, it's mostly girls, you know, but then some of my friends, they'll think that's, like, for losers who can't get any.
Oh, wait a minute.
Don't hang around with those guys. You get them out of your life early.
All right.
My concern is this some sort of sexual compulsion? Is there addiction in your family anywhere?
No.
Okay. And you really were not abused in any way growing
up?
No.
You don't have a girlfriend, do you?
Yeah.
You do?
Yeah.
Boy.
What's she doing?
I'm just hoping she's not listening right now.
Well, listen, maybe it's good. He has no wind in his sail at all.
That's true.
But I've heard from, like, that girls get more, like, better orgasms.
Than men?
No, from guys with curved penises.
Oh wait, that's right. His question was the curved penis.
That's right.
How curved
depends which way
about.
Curves.
Take vitamin E, Nick. Vitamin E will decrease. It's actually from an irritation and scarring on one side of the penis that pulls it in that direction. Vitamin E, and if it starts getting to the point that you have trouble getting an erection or a painful erection, you must see a urologist, okay?
All right,
Nick. Have fun with yourself.
Okay.
What do you do? Do you usually watch movies?
Yeah, I watch movies, yeah.
Do you have a VCR in your room?
Yeah.
No. Okay, that's it. I would confiscate that immediately. There's nothing but evil can come from a VCR in a young lad's room, if you really think about it. What good could come from it? Best case scenario, he's sitting around watching, Smoking the Bandit 3 for the 18th jillionth time. You know, whatever it is, and that's a best case scenario. Nothing good can come of it.
What they say young people aren't working out enough, though. So what about you maybe doing those Tybo videos?
I'm sure. Oh, he's breaking a sweat, all right, but it ain't.
Oh,
yes. This is the theme from Taboo 2, one of my favorite old porn movies I sort of broke myself in on. But I was 19 and out of the house. Amanda?
Hi.
You're 19. What's up?
Yeah, I've been going out with this guy for about 5 years now, and maybe about the last 10 months, we've been having a lot of troubles, and we kind of grew further and further apart, where I really don't love him that much anymore,
yeah.
And he kind of manipulates me to get back with him, like, every day after we get in fights and everything, and I just need to know how to get a clean break away from this guy.
Yeah. I don't understand. What is he doing exactly?
What I wanted to be was still be friends with him,
yeah.
And he don't want that friend relationship.
Well, No. That never works.
And let me explain something, ladies. It's not that we don't want the friend relationship. We just want the sex relationship.
Wow, wait a minute. Yeah. Somebody listening to us from London here.
Amanda?
Yeah?
You guys been going out since 14?
Yeah, I was 13 when I met him.
All right, you just got, how old is he?
He's 20.
You have to break up. You have to stay with it.
Yeah.
It's like quitting smoking or something. It gets easier each day that goes by.
Yeah.
The crucial part is the first 2 or 3 weeks. Don't give in. Stay on your own.
Don't talk to him.
Just break it off.
Really? And
don't do that any we can still be friends nonsense.
No, that's just awful.
He's not interested in being friends.
Well, we haven't had sex in anything for like 7 months, so.
All right.
It's just that he does that. You know, if you still love me, then you would.
No, please don't get into. Listen, you got to cut him off. That's the only option you have, to focus on this business of being friends. We are trying to let him down. Of course, you don't want to hurt him, but that hurts him more.
Oh, okay.
All right. All right, there, Amanda.
All right, thanks.
All right, good luck to you.
All right.
Amanda was 19. Sounded like she was from Oshkosh, and well into her 40s. Isn't that amazing?
Yeah.
Then we had the guy from the Israeli Commandos who was 15, who sounded like he was 35.
Yeah.
And then we had Ray, who was, well into his 20s, and he sounded like he was 4.
Right. We'll have that throughout the night, too. There'll be guys you talk to that... your chronological age doesn't dictate all that much. As a matter of fact, when I'm in charge, I'm not going to set arbitrary numbers as far as like get your driver's license, buy beer, whatever it is, and join the service, whatever that is. I'm going to size everyone up individually. I may see a 12, 13 year old I think can handle a 6-pack of beer.
Oh, God.
Then again, there may be some chicks well into their 30s who I won't issue a license to. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, I
just feel I'm going to feel everyone out individually, see where they're at. There's some kids who are 11 who should be in the Army. There really are. And then there's guys in their mid-30s who just who I won't let buy beer. You know what I mean? Why not? So people are so different at 18 or 21.
I know.
Why just make it so arbitrary that way?
Adam, you got to hear this.
I'm gonna get to know each and every one of my constituency.
I'm in the college room at DrDrew.com. It's a college chat room. And there's somebody with a screen name of Mini-Me 333 who says they're listening from London right now.
Why?
And that I'm trying to figure out how they listen, and that there's a huge following in London for this program.
Really?
They must be listening on the net.
That's what I'm figuring. Yeah. They're not telling me yet how they
How do they listen on the net, though? How do they listen to the radio show on the net?
I'm waiting to hear, but now everyone in the world is going into this room now.
Here's the important question.
Broadcast.com.
Yeah, probably.
Do we get any money? No.
No.
So who cares? Gavin? You're 15. Hey, listen, any of you limeys over there, my ex-girlfriend, I want to explain something for a second. My ex-girlfriend, the one that was a stripper, you know, we had a pretty tumultuous relationship for a few years, about 7-8 years ago. Then she dumped me and she got married and she moved to England. And I want to tell her I'm a big star. See, that's...
Oh, you want to get in touch with her?
Yeah, I want to get...
Talk to these people in London. There's a whole group of them.
I want to get in touch with her because she moved out like 6 years ago, 7 years ago. I was still swinging a hammer. And I want to let her know I'm a big millionaire, big star... high-powered mover and shaker now. I really want her to, you know, be upset.
Whatever.
And she won't come back from England, and I don't think she knows anything. So I'd like somebody to tell her.
Why don't you just feel good about the fact that your teachers have to listen to your crap every night?
Oh, those imbeciles.
Oh, they're
Gavin,
telling me
thanks for nothing.
They listen on the web, broadcast.com. Hey.
Gavin, you're 15.
Yeah, hey. I chewed tobacco yesterday, and I chewed, like, pretty heavily. And lately, my scalp has been feeling, like, really tingly and dry, and, like, I've been really dizzy lately.
Yeah.
I don't know what's up.
When did you chewed tobacco?
Yeah.
When was this?
About yesterday. Yeah, yesterday.
Well, chewing tobacco is an amazingly substantial or potent dose of nicotine.
Mm-hmm.
And people can feel rather crummy from that for a day. I could see that.
It can get you sick, yeah.
It can get you sick, and it can get you severely addicted. That is actually one of the more difficult addictions to nicotine to quit,
yeah,
if not
like
the worst.
I was going to puke, and, like, I've been feeling pretty bad lately.
Yeah, so you... I taste vomit when I hear that sound effect.
I just love the gurgling at the end that he does. He's such an amazing actor, that David Alan Grier. He does everything well. Fake vomit, he does well. They should give him an Oscar for the fake vomit. Hey, you know what? I swear to I'm going to call him up. I'm going to say, David, listen, you got to get yourself a role where you vomit because you will get the Oscar. It'll look great on your reel. Hey, Gavin?
Yeah.
All right. Drink plenty of fluids and don't dip anymore, okay?
All right, cool.
There you
all
go.
Right, thanks.
All right. Drew, start doing your job over
right
here, stateside, right?
There you are.
All right. We're going to take ourselves a break when we come back. Zeddy Vaughn, she's 18, drinks all the time, can't get turned on while drunk, can't get turned on while drunk,
good,
yet drinks all the time. Let me just talk to her for 1 second. Yvonne?
Hello?
You can't get turned on when you're drunk?
No.
But you drink constantly?
Yeah.
Okay, hold on.
Okay.
You drunk now?
Almost.
Okay, well, I have another shot. We'll go into commercial, and we'll get you all primed up for when we come back, all right?
Okay.
All right. Hill Harper is our guest tonight. City of Angels is the name of his show, 8 o'clock Wednesday, CBS. We'll take ourselves a little break, and we'll get back with the Drew. I'm at a loss for words. The quickly drunken, no, help me here,
the
Drew.
The constantly intoxicated.
Thank you, Yvonne, after this.
LoveLine, 1-800-LOVE-191. Back in a minute.
Well, it's worth hearing.
This is LoveLine on Outrageous Talk Radio, 100.7 The Buzz. This is LoveLine on Outrageous Talk Radio, 100.7 The Buzz.
It's LoveLine. I'm Adam Carolla. That is Dr. Drew. Henry Rollins will be in here tomorrow night. Hill Harper is our guest tonight. You know him from City of Angels. Wednesday nights, 8 o'clock, CBS. Also on March 31st, the Skulls will be released, and he will be all over that as well. We left off speaking to Yvonne, who's 18. She's becoming drunk as we speak. Yvonne?
Yeah.
You drunk?
Almost. Yet.
Almost.
Yeah, almost.
What are you drinking?
Tequila.
Oh. Mm. Every night?
Huh?
Every night?
True, use the mic. You have shots of tequila at home?
I went and got a bottle tonight.
Oh,
A half gallon. You drink hard liquor every night, Yvonne?
Yeah.
Oh, all
right. You understand that's going to be a big problem, right?
Yeah.
Okay.
Want to do something about that?
Do what?
The part about you drinking hard liquor every night?
Yeah.
You want to try to stop doing that, maybe?
I could stop if I want to. We get bored. We live in the desert. It sucks. Okay. And
no, I don't
think... Drew, as long as she has a good reason.
Yeah.
I mean, living in the desert.
That's pretty much every addict's des, is they can stop if they want to, but then they find out they can't. At this stage, actually, even as heavily as you're drinking at your age, you might be able to stop if you want to. Pretty much every addict and alcoholic can control it early on. It's just as it goes on, eventually the drives become so powerful that your ability to control becomes completely overwhelmed.
All right. Well, Yvonne...
Plus, you're hanging out with a bunch of losers.
Yeah. I'm not hanging out with nobody but my brother.
Really?
Yeah.
Well, that's what we mean.
Oh.
All right, Yvonne, what are your plans for the future?
I'm not sure yet.
All right, you're going to keep it up in the air?
Yeah.
College?
No. I had a kid when I was 15.
Oh, okay. Where is your kid?
He's upstairs sleeping, and I'm downstairs.
Okay, see, when I'm in charge, you'll be removed from that house. Yvonne, come on, you have a kid. Don't you want to be a good mother to the child?
Yeah, I am. I only drink, like, at nighttime.
Okay. All right, so if there's a fire or something, you'll just be passed out. Right through it. Hey, Yvonne, seriously, where's your dad? Where's your mom?
My mom's upstairs sleeping. My stepdad is sleeping. My real dad is dead.
Uh-huh.
How old were you when he died?
He was in prison most of my life, so I think I was like 13.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Well, where's the father of your child?
He lives in San Bernardino.
Oh, okay. Well, this is as long as you've created a better life for your youngin'.
Oh.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's not like the biological father's in prison. He's in San Bernardino, which is his own kind of incarceration, but it's not technically being behind bars, although it's, I don't know. I'd be curious if you took a lot
He's
of prisoners
and
said,
no
listen, you want to you want to stay in for another year or you want to go to San Bernardino? They'd be like, how long? A year? We'll ride it out. I'm very comfortable here.
Well, I mean, how do we even...
Who cares? Listen, Yvonne...
Yeah.
Listen to me.
Right.
Do not have any more kids. Do you hear me?
Yeah, I know.
What are you doing about it?
I am on Depo Provera.
Good.
There you go.
Good.
Good girl.
Fantastic.
And do something for yourself and for your child.
Booze all you want. Just don't have any more kids.
Go check out AA. Go check out some treatment, because you really got a mess evolving here.
Well, I'm not, like, really messed up. I could quit if I want.
Yvonne, good. Forget it. Stop saying that, because that's not true.
Can I talk about why I called?
All right, go.
No.
Real quick.
I don't care if you're not horny. I don't care. I'm glad.
I have to...
I hope your vagina dries up like the Dead Sea.
Oh, yeah?
Yes.
Alcohol is poisonous to human tissue, and it will poison sexual functioning, and poison your brain function. It will really disturb a lot of that. So just, it dissolves the nerves in the pelvic area that's responsible for sexual arousal. So it's no surprise that you'd be having some problems.
Well,
some
she's will become 18.
Yeah. It will, but she's really going at it. It will become permanent in the next 10 years or so.
Good. Kelly.
Hello?
You're 20.
Yeah.
What's up?
Well, I've been listening to the show for a really long time. There was always a question that I always attributed to my life, and that was about women dating older men.
Yeah.
Yeah. And it was always due to some psychological factor in the girl's life. And the other night I was...
Not adults dating other adults. We're talking about young women being taken advantage of by older men. We understand why young women are attracted to older men. The problem is the guys that would engage in that behavior are disturbed by definition. And the question is, why would a girl think those guys are okay?
Unless they're producers. Then it's all right. That's the only stipulation. And Drew, we don't make that point enough.
Uh-huh.
Go ahead there, Kelly.
Well, a guy called the other night, and he had the same question. He was young, and he dated older women. It was Friday night.
Right.
And your answer was that he was just more mature for his age, and therefore he related better with older women.
Right.
That's, you know, right. It seemed like...
It's unfair.
No, it was a question that I learned, like, I took on your show and, like, about father issues and bad sexual experiences.
But you've had all that.
Yeah, I'm a candidate, you know, I'm a really good candidate, you know, for being, like, psychologically, sexually screwed.
Okay.
And,
there you go.
So I attributed to, like, the advice about other callers that you gave to my life. But then when that guy called, and it was completely different.
That's right.
And it was I felt it was really biased, and this thing that I've been trying to address issues that
okay, let me address that. First off, the guy called, I think he was 22 years old. He was dating a 30-year-old.
Yeah, that's our point. Adults dating adults is a totally different phenomenon.
Well, shut up. Shut up, Drew. Let me
Totally different.
All right, but let me finish my point. Can we shut Drew's mic off so I can finish my point, please? We'd asked him about the woman he was dating, about himself, and that kind of thing, and we'd sussed it out and basically gave him the green light. There is differences between men and women in many, many topics, on many topics. There really are.
So there should be nothing psychologically meant, like psychologically wrong with a guy in the same situation.
There can definitely be issues, possibly different issues. But in this guy's case, he was 22, he was dating a 30-year-old. He wasn't 15 and dating a 27-year-old.
That's a totally different situation.
Well, I'm not promiscuous at all.
Kelly, you're not listening to us at all.
Oh, who cares what you do, Kelly?
Kelly, you're not listening to us.
I know. She's so reactionary.
Yeah.
She can't hear a goddamn word I'm saying.
I'm sorry. Go ahead.
All right.
The thing is, adults dating adults is a totally... If you were 22 and told us you were dating 35-year-olds, we'd say, oh, well. It might be an issue for you. It might not. But, you know, the guy's in a different phase in his life. Be careful. If you're 18 dating a 28-year-old or 17 dating a 25-year-old, we're going to take issue with it. Whether you're male or female, frankly.
All right. But... listen to me, everybody. People call the show and they go, well, you gave a different advice to a guy than you did to a girl. Let me explain why. Because you're different, you idiots. There's a big difference between men and women. Hey, listen to the show. If there's a 15-year-old girl who calls in, said she got drunk at a party and, you know, sort of lost her wits, and a guy came up and got on top of her, we say call the cops. That's rape. If a 15-year-old guy says he had a few drinks at a party and a 6-year-old chick crawled on top of him, we say way to go.
No, we don't. If he's traumatized.
We don't tell him to call the cops. The point is there's differences. There's just differences. There really are. It's all right.
But this, she's got such issues in this area and so angry about it, she doesn't even hear the fact that they're are no differences in the area that she's addressing.
Right.
That it's the same, and it's not an issue in that age group.
Okay. I don't know. I can't tell you what my feelings are. All I can tell you is I'm very adamant about all of them. That's the approach I'm taking tonight. I'm not going to articulate myself, but there's going to be a lot of zest and verve behind everything.
Speak your truth.
That's right, even if I don't personally know what it is. Hill Harper's our guest tonight. We will take ourselves a little break, and we'll be right back after this.
LoveLine with Adam Carolla and Dr. Drew.
1-800-LOVE-191. Oh, wow, wow.
This is LoveLine on Outrageous Talk Radio, 100.7 The Buzz.
LoveLine on
radio station.
Outrageous Talk Radio, 100.7 The Buzz.
I can't believe I've heard some of the things that have been said here. You all ought to be ashamed of yourselves.
KQBZ
yes, LoveLine. I'm Adam. That's Drew. Phone number 1-800-LOVE-191. Our guest tonight is Hill Harper from City of Angels, 8 o'clock, CBS, Wednesday nights. Also, The Skulls, which will hit the theaters the 31st of March. And tomorrow night, we have our old friend Henry Rollins in here.
Hey, can I say I've been monitoring the chat rooms at drdrew.com, and you guys are not asking questions that I can really bring up.
You idiots.
Yeah, here's one. What will weed and alcohol do to antidepressants? Well, obviously, not let them work properly. And if you have a weed and alcohol problem, that needs to be treated. Don't allow depression to be treated as an excuse for the treatment of addiction. And also, we reached 100,000 registered users at drew.com this weekend, and it really is quite a lively, interesting community we've got going now.
100,000?
100,000 registered.
Your wife registered that many times?
48,000 of those. But it's really an interesting community that's building, and people are telling us they're having a great time, getting good information, and so I appreciate that. And free condoms. And it'll be interesting commercials out starting tomorrow.
Interesting commercials on what?
With Allie Landry and...
On the TV?
Yeah, on the TV. You'll see them.
Really?
I'll bring them in to show you. I watch your tapes all the time.
On cable?
Cable and network.
Network?
Mm-hmm.
UPN or network? Yeah.
And it's network. I know UPN will be, it'll be like all the ones where Felicity and all that stuff plays, you know, those sorts of
things. That's WB.
Okay. WB. Yeah.
Jessica? Yeah, not really networking. Jessica?
Yes?
You're 16.
Yes.
What's up? I'm sure MTV's chomping at the bit to get some of those Dr. Drew commercials.
You know what's
on
bizarre?
There.
We're going to have some playing on them.
They offered you quite a discount. Listen to this. What?
Didn't want to play them? Too risque.
Oh,
and,
really?
And believe me, these commercials are as bland as they can be, especially for MTV.
MTV is
about a place for kids to get health information.
MTV is not interested in the message. They're more interested in the crotch shot. They have a sort of retarded logic over there where they can watch the grind grind marathon, a bunch of underage chicks mincing about in bikinis and a guy on a mechanics creeper going in between her legs. But you say pissed off on the station and their tail feathers go flying.
No, I'm teasing. They're
retarded, please.
No, they're not.
Oh, who cares? That show's over. They'll never hire you back. Jessica?
Yes.
You're 16.
Mm-hmm.
What's up?
Well, first I just wanted to let Adam know that I'm not an egotard. So,
thank you.
You know.
You have that young girl voice, though. You worry us a little bit.
I just recently went out with my mother's friend, who is a 39-year-old man.
Mm-hmm.
And he's a trusted friend, you know. For a long time.
Of your mother's?
And yes.
Why'd he take you out?
Well, he was my friend too, you know.
Yeah.
40-year-old.
Huh?
Yeah. 40-year-old guy. Did someone just come into the cabin?
Excuse me?
Okay. So he took you out. Where were you guys going?
The movies.
All right. I don't trust him.
And I trusted him and he just he spoke to me in an inappropriate way.
Yeah.
Okay, did you tell your mom?
No, not yet. I don't know how to confront her with it. I don't know, I'm having all these awful feelings.
All right, well, who is this guy? Friend of your mom's?
Yeah.
Where's like your boyfriend kind of thing, or what?
Oh, no.
Is your dad around?
He's around.
Why don't you tell your dad about this
What
guy?
Do you mean, around? Where is he?
He doesn't live with me. You know, my mother and father were divorced.
Yeah.
And he lives in San Francisco.
Uh-huh. And where do you live?
I live in Marina Del Rey.
Oh, all right.
What if you told your dad about this?
So he's just a quick 11-hour car ride away?
Yeah.
All right. He'll be there this time tomorrow.
Yeah.
Do you talk to your dad much?
Yeah, I do.
You do?
You know, we don't have a really close relationship, but I'm not, you know, I wasn't, you know, attracted to this guy at all.
Did he do anything to you physically?
Yeah, you know.
What'd he do?
He just, he...
Was that R2-D2 in the background there?
Or Mom.
I just can't, you know, I can't speak.
Mom just walked in.
Come here and give me a hug.
When we were in the movie, you know, he was telling me, you know, that he loved me as a daughter and everything, but he was feeling infatuated with me.
All right, hold on there, Jessica.
Okay.
This guy's a pig. Your mother has something going on with her because she really shouldn't be associating with guys like this.
Yeah. Well, I didn't even know that.
I know. But when you get older, you understand that people should know, especially adults should know what kind of people they're hanging around.
He's a very intelligent and studious.
Okay. How long has your mom been friends with him?
For years. I'm not exactly sure.
Okay. You just tell your mom. You tell your mom.
Yeah,
that's fine.
You've got to.
Has anyone ever tried anything like this on you before?
You
got that voice.
There, you know. A lot of that. I don't know. Like older boys my age don't seem to be interested in me at all. But you know, older men really just. I don't know what it is.
All right, Jessica. Did anyone ever rape you or molest you?
Nope.
Huh?
Nope.
Where'd you get that voice?
I don't know.
It's not.
You a virgin?
Yes.
Okay, good. You keep that hymen.
I Okay.
You send it to me. I'm going to hang on to it. I don't trust you with it.
Okay.
You understand? I'll give it back to you on your 21st birthday or when you get married.
All right.
All right. That's my new plan. I want all the virgins who are listening within the sound of my voice, send me their hymen. I'll watch out for it. It's like a designated driver with the vagina. You cannot be trusted. I will look after it. It's like, you know, when you go to a party and people collect the keys, people are getting loaded. I'll hold the keys. I'll give them back to you when I see you're sobered up a little bit. I'll collect all the hymens. I'll hang on to them. And don't worry, I won't just keep them in a hamper or something. I'll go ahead and label them and stuff, you know?
Oh, gosh. Catalog them.
I'll use them. You know, you know what the valet does with the keys? You know, he puts a little tag on it. He puts it in a little square in the little box with the lock on it.
I'm imagining something at the cleaners. We have those racks that moves around.
Oh, yeah. There you go, Drew. That's thinking. That's better. Yeah. Yeah, and you know what's funny about I swear to Christ, remind me to get onto this in a second. I'll get back to the hymens for a second. But every goddamn time I go to the cleaner, I spot the goddamn thing. It's always funny. It's like, name is Karakawa. Yes, Karakawa. Yes. What'd you have? It was like a red shirt and like a white shirt and, I don't know, two shirts. Well, hold on. And, you know, guy starts spinning around. He'll never see it, too. No, I don't know. I don't know what goes on with the labeling at the dry cleaner, but whatever labeling, it's just a total ruse. They don't label anything. They put it by a label so you think there's some, you know, method to their madness, but no. They just, you know what their plan is? We keep spinning around until you point at something.
Yes, that's it.
It's a weird, it's like a shill game. You know, they go, Corolla, let's see, look under C, and, you know, they have all these labels and numbers there. But here's the reality. They hold their finger on the button until the thing spins around enough. Eventually, you'll go, that one. That one right there. And then the guy will pull it off and hand you. But he'll never go and find it himself. It'll never be in the slot that he'd put it in. I don't know. I got to get to the bottom of that one day. I'm going to send my team to look into that.
Well, when you have the hymens, you have your own catalog.
The hymens, yes. I will catalog.
It can be like kind of like a club.
Yeah, the hymen club. The parents parents will write a letter. They'll enclose the hymen in a... I'm also going to need a self-addressed stamped envelope to return it at some point.
Mm.
And put a couple stamps on it because Lord knows what postage could be by then. Right? Goes up a couple cents every year. Put it in a nice manila envelope. Send that out to me. I'll hang on to it. And then... You send me, enclosed is the copy of birth control.
No, I got
I mean, sorry, birth certificate.
No,
so I can document the age. And then on the 21st birthday, or upon college graduation, or upon marriage, I will send the hymen back so it can be
the web is the purpose
by
way to
the
do
suitor
this.
For
the
choice.
The web is the way to do this.
Really?
Hymen.com. Oh, yeah. Yeah.
Really?
Yeah.
All right.
Yeah. Yourhymen.com should be.
Yourhymen.com.
Yeah.
All right. Write that down. Oh, man. That'd be
somebody's
a great job.
Somebody's taking that name right now. Probably.
House full of hymens. Taylor?
Hi.
You're 16.
Yeah.
You still have your hymen?
Yeah.
Would you like send it in? Have me keep an eye on it?
Sure.
And not only will I look after it, but before I send it back, I'll water test it, and I'll give it armor all in.
So first of all, I just want to tell you how much I love you, Adam, because you're like my favorite person ever.
Wow. Whoa.
But my question. Okay, so I got together with my friend who I'd been friends with for about a year.
All right, hold on. Drew, that's enough monkeying with the computer.
Sorry.
You've been at it all night. Now, come on. Get with the show.
And so we got together, and we were in a relationship for probably about a month, and that was it. But we broke up because things were just too weird and everything. But then we kind of lost our friendship. And now he's calling me again, telling me he realizes how cool I am, how he wants to be my friend again, and all this
asshole.
Weird stuff.
Yeah. When was this that you were part of ways?
That we were together?
Yeah.
Or when we broke up?
Both.
Okay. We were together about 2 months ago, and we broke up about a month ago.
And he broke up with you?
No, it was pretty mutual.
No, he broke up with you.
No, it was
No, I'm
mutual.
Thinking she broke up with him.
You broke up with him?
Kinda.
Yeah.
He's kinda needy.
Yeah.
Oh, he's done. Done. Yep. Well, that's it for him.
Well, I think he's a really cool guy, and I want to be friends with him. But
well, he doesn't want to be friends.
You're gonna torture him.
Oh.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
He, by the way, he was into you from the beginning.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's what he told me.
Oh, how did I know that? Magic.
Yeah, guys get into girls from the beginning. Once in a while, the girls give in to the guy. Then the guy starts getting clingy. Then the girl freaks out.
Then the guy, he's going to be 2 years into this.
Yeah, but he thought it was really weird, too. So
Taylor, he's going to dedicate 2 years to obsessing about you now. Yeah. I guarantee it.
So why was he such a jerk to me when we weren't, like...
He wasn't jerky. He thought he was being cool. He was into you.
Oh.
You mean when you broke up?
Yeah.
Why was he jerk? Because his feelings were hurt and he was trying to salvage some pride.
Yeah.
Oh, okay. All right. Thank you.
How old is he?
He's 17.
All right, Taylor, listen to me. The best thing you can do for you and him is just to give it a break. 6 months.
Okay.
But really, I see some stalking in her future.
Yeah.
Really, you have to really be firm, okay?
Okay.
Not a friendship for a while.
Okay.
I wish, I wish women had been crueler and kinder to me when I was a young'un. Oh, such an idiot. Idiot.
You and I share
Jesus
that heritage.
Christ.
We do.
Really?
Oh, yeah.
Bill, didn't you
that? I'm with you.
You couldn't get the message when you were 16, 17, could you?
Just available for abuse.
Yeah.
You'd get locked into one woman, and that'd be it. And you'd start obsessing over it, and then she'd notice it, and then you were cooked.
And then a couple years after high school, you run into her, and you're like, this is the woman I was into. My God.
Oh, I'm 35 now. I see those women now, I just start laughing like a hyena. I'm like, listen, how old is your daughter? Do you have any kids yet? 13? All right, let me get my number. About 2 years, ever give me a call. Yeah, it's so sad. They're all fat and old and ugly now. And look at me, I'm a big star. Millionaire, Drew. Literally, millionaire.
You and Bill Gates.
That's right. Richard?
Hello?
That's my new thing I tell people. I'm literally a millionaire. Literally. Richard?
Hey.
All right, so what's up? You're 19.
Yeah, 19. Yeah, I've been smoking pot for like 8 years.
Mm-hmm. Very good.
And like a week and a half ago, I had quit, and I've been taking NyQuil ever since.
Yeah.
So
you just switched over to alcohol.
Yeah, actually, I was wondering about that. Not as much as the alcohol as the ingredient that makes you sleep.
That's alcohol.
Oh, isn't there something else in there that puts you down a little bit?
I have a bottle right here. I just can't pronounce it.
Go ahead, try. Go.
Well, if you hadn't smoked pot since you were 11, maybe you could.
Yeah, tell me about it. Let's see.
Hey, listen, callers. It's no fun when I beat you up and you go along with it.
Richard, you got to get involved with MA. You can't switch.
Oh, that's another thing. I was doing that through the online, and I was wondering, that's probably not as good as going to those meetings, but it was easier to...
You have to go to a meeting. Online. You have to go to a meeting. You have to get a sponsor, or you will start escalating the alcohol or switch over to speed or go back to pot. It just doesn't stop without treatment. It just doesn't.
Okay, so yeah, NyQuil's no good?
NyQuil is alcohol, and large is a very concentrated alcohol.
Really?
Okay.
And you can't do this without treatment. It just doesn't work
now,
like that.
Now, what is the ingredient in there that makes you tired, though? I can't
think of it. It's hydro... okay, 1 second. I swear to God, I'll get it for you.
All right. Should I have to spell it?
Okay.
You want to spell it?
Can you spell it for... Hey, Richard, do you have to put the phone down to get the NyQuil thing up to your face?
I got bad eyesight, man. I'm trying to take it out.
Hey, Richard.
Yes.
Stop using the F word, you retard.
Okay.
You're on the goddamn radio.
Okay.
Are you ready?
Active ingredient, dextrothemethan.
That's nothing. That's nothing. Nothing.
It isn't?
That will not make you sleep. It's the alcohol that makes you sleep.
Really?
How come NyQuil tastes just like Jägermeister?
Because that's also what it is.
I mean, Jägermeister's a little better for it. But listen, Drew, I know there's something else in there, too, because it makes you a little wacky.
Oh, I think there's some stimulant, actually. I think there's a little
something
decongestant
in there. No, here's what I'm saying.
Maybe there's antihistamine or something.
Yeah, shot of NyQuil is not a shot of booze.
It's more than that, yeah. It's a lot of booze, for one thing.
No, but... It's not a higher alcohol content than a shot of tequila. Oh,
not the tequila.
Well, listen, if it's the same as a shot of red wine or something, that's not going to make you weird.
Yeah.
Even if it's a shot of tequila, capital tequila, not going to make me weird. But the NyQuil, I can feel it.
Okay.
So there's something in there, is what he's saying. Whatever it is, get off it. June?
Yeah?
You're 16. Hi. Hey, what's up?
First, I just love you guys. I listen every night.
Thanks.
My question is, I have very strong feelings for my best friend, who's a guy, and we've kind of fooled around before. Mm-hmm. And coming from a guy's point of view, if I told him, like, the way I felt, do you think it would change anything or make him, like, I don't know, less appreciative of me?
No, if he was drunk, you might score.
But he's not in the way you are.
I tried that already.
Yeah, see, he's not in the way you are, June.
Yeah. So sad.
Right? Am I right?
Well, yeah, I mean, you know, when we made out, he was drunk, and so was I.
Yeah, no, June, he's just not in the same way.
Well, so do you think it would ruin our friendship?
No, I think...
Guys don't care.
Yeah,
he probably already knows.
It might help clear the air a little bit, but don't expect that to compel him into a relationship.
And women are always worried about ruining the friendship. Guys don't really care about it.
Well, he said to me that he actually cared about... how our friendship would turn out if we went out, but that was like a year.
Well, that's an excuse for not going out.
I mean, see, I ain't into. Yeah, listen, you know, guys, they're crude, but they're not that crude.
Well, they're very concerned about friendships.
Go, well, listen, your ass is a little wide for me, so we'll not be going out. They go, listen, I'm worried about, no, you're a beautiful woman, you're very attractive. Yes, I find you attractive. I'm just worried about a friendship.
Well, he didn't lie. He told me my thighs needed work.
Oh, he's awful.
You're fat. That son of a bitch.
Only my thighs.
You want to go out with that guy? Your thighs need
some
work.
Worse than the average jerk.
Well, I told him his face needed work.
After the thighs?
Yeah.
Maybe you work his face over with your thighs. Hey, June.
Yeah.
Now listen, I don't like where you're heading. You're 16 years old. I see right where you're heading, right for the trailer park.
No, I don't think so. I have college plans and all that.
You do? Yeah, make I sure have you, college plans,
make
too.
Make sure you pursue them. How do you pick that up out of her?
I smell trouble.
What?
What?
I don't trust this guy.
Yeah.
I'm worried about her thighs. What college you think you're going to?
Evergreen.
Evergreen?
In Washington State.
Never heard of it. What is it?
It's in Tacoma. It's a community college.
No, listen. Listen. Yeah. June, let me explain something. You're 16 years old.
Yes, I am.
Let me explain how schools work, how college plans work. Mm-hmm. Let me explain how life works. I'll explain my life, and this is how all years work. Age 7, I'm going to be a pirate. Okay. By the time I was 9, I was going to be an astronaut. When I was 11, I'd be a professional football player.
Right.
Then when I was 13, I was going to Harvard.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Then 14, 15, I was going to UCLA. No, I was going to Stanford, I think, 14, 15. 16, I was going to UCLA. 17, I was going to Cal State Northridge. 18, Valley College. 19, I was cleaning carpets.
So she's at a community college at 16.
That means she's going to be like shoveling dung at a turkey farm at 17 and a half. She's earlier than even I was.
Yeah,
I didn't get to
heady.
Junior college until 18. I didn't dream of junior college. I didn't have that lofty dream of junior college until 18. So when you're thinking at 16, when you're already, that's like you're thrown in the towel. Hey, you might as well drop out. Hey, here's the beauty of junior college. You go right now.
I will never be shoveling dung.
You can go to junior college tomorrow.
I probably could.
You don't even need to sign up. Just show up. Well, you just walk right in and sit down.
Hey, I have like a 3.8 grade average, so...
Well, why are you thinking about junior college?
Why'd you think about real college?
Because I don't have the money for it.
Oh, listen.
There are grants and loans and all sorts of things. That money excuse does not go
over. Does not fly, yeah. All colleges have access to...
Don't you got any Comanche in you or anything?
Oh, I'm one of those trained assassin Jews.
Oh, you're Jewish?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, they don't have anything for them.
No.
You just got to get a higher...
Yeah, I got cheap Jewish grandparents.
Oh, you do? Oh, that sucks. Jewish and poor.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
No. Cheap.
Oh, it's horrible.
There's still grants and loans for you.
Yeah, but you got to go to Israel. That's the problem. You know, that's the problem. We're getting back to the Jews, but that's horrible. That's worse than just being a white guy and poor, being Jewish and poor, because it's like the Jews, they went, listen, don't worry about the Jews. They take care of themselves. I'm not getting any grants for those people. Let Spielberg put them through college or something. Then you get that rare. It's not that often, but you get that cheap, poor Jew family. Well, now
cheap.
You're screwed.
Yeah, they may be chip rich.
Well, hold on.
It's really screwed
financially.
Yeah.
Are they poor, too?
No, they're actually quite
Okay, Drew is right. Drew had a theory about finding a poor Jewish family in America. He wasn't able to find
it. And poor at the same time.
Well, my parents were cheap and poor.
How can that be?
Well, here's how my parents were cheap and poor.
They wouldn't let him supersize his fries.
They didn't have enough money to buy me stuff, but if they did, they wouldn't have bought it anyway. No, here's how my parents were cheap and poor. I hope they're listening. Because we were poor, but we were not dirt poor. We were just, my mom was on welfare for a while and a little food stamps and that kind of stuff. But people had, my dad was like a substitute school teacher or something. There was enough. The difference between a pair of tough skins and a pair of regular Levi's that you wouldn't be made fun of at school was about $1.95 in 1975. You know what I mean? I mean, it was like tough skins were $9.95 and the Levi's were $12.
You get the tough skins.
I got the tough skins. Yeah. We were poor, but not so poor that they couldn't have kicked in another $2 and got the goddamn Levi's. But no, that's cheap and poor.
Yeah.
See what I'm saying?
Yeah, yeah. Mm-hmm.
All right. Now that we all know why I'm in therapy, we'll take ourselves a little break. Gil Harper's our guest. You can find him on City of Angels, CBS, 8 o'clock, Wednesday nights. When we come back, we'll speak to Tobias, whose 18 girlfriend won't give him oral sex because he's uncircumcised. She wants to know how to get her. We'll tell him after this.
Come on, baby.
Yo, Loveline will be right back, homie.
Mom, I'm so mad at you. I am so mad at you, Mom.
This is Loveline on Outrageous Talk Radio, 100.7 The Buzz.
It's the Loveline. I'm Adam. That is Drew. Phone number 1-800-LOVE-191. Oh, Henry Rollins tomorrow night. Hill Harper's our guest tonight. He's on City of Angels, CBS, Wednesday nights, 8 o'clock. Also, The Skulls. The movie will be coming out on the 31st of March.
Every time I hear Henry Rollins' name, it reminds me of this African-American actor named Howard Rollins, who died of AIDS a few years ago. He was on that show, In the Heat of the Night.
Oh, yeah.
Great actor. Great actor.
Yeah, what had he... I don't know his full story, but I do remember hearing about it. He had it for was he living with it for a long time?
Yeah, I think he was living with it for a while, and I think Carol O'Connor was a huge supporter of his, but he had a lot of drug abuse issues and a lot of things going on, and Carol O'Connor, I guess, was just really great with him and keeping him on the show, even though he had problems and all sorts of things.
Sort of relating to it since he dealt with his son's problems.
I think so.
Yeah, he was, he did some features and stuff, too, though, right?
Yeah.
Yeah.
And these big eyes.
Yeah, it was a real intense-looking guy.
Right.
Yeah, he kind of reminded me of, Blair Underwood. I'm trying to think of another black actor that he reminded me of. Or maybe I just saw him enough and it was him that was reminding me of,
right, of him.
Him. That can happen. Smoke enough pot. Tobias?
Yeah.
What's up there, Tobias?
I'm just chilly.
All right. Well, let's see. Your girlfriend won't give you oral sex because you're uncircumcised.
Right.
Is that what she says?
Huh? No, she don't say it. Like, she don't say that's the reason, but I'm having a pretty good feeling that's the reason.
Yikes.
Why do you think that's the reason?
I mean, there couldn't be no other reason. If I'm doing her, you know what I'm saying?
Some women are just not into doing this, Tobias.
Huh?
Some women, Tobias is shocked, obviously, but some women are just not into doing this.
We talked about it before any of it went down. And she says it was down until she seen, you know what I'm saying?
Well, that's why you get her to sign that document that I could have sent out to your house, so she has to. By, you know, in a court of law, we'll have her do that right there in the courtroom. How old is she, Tobias?
She's 19.
Uh-huh. And so you figure she's done this before?
Yeah, I know she's done this before.
All right. You're good and clean down there, Tobias?
Yeah.
Yeah. All right. Why don't you take a shower and then peel it back so it looks like what she's used to, and then she won't know the difference. Tell her you got circumcised last weekend. I mean, just give it to her in the way she wants to see it. You get an erection and peel the skin back. Can you do that?
Pull the skin back.
Yeah.
Man, she just be acting funny though, man.
Well, listen, I don't know what to tell her. You want us to talk to her?
Huh?
You want us to talk to her?
Yeah, you can kind of call her.
Yeah, where is she? She at home?
Huh?
She at home now?
Well, Skip, what time is it?
I don't know. Where are you calling from?
Cincinnati, 2:30. No, she at work right now.
She's at work?
You can call her at work, though.
All right. What kind of place does she work at?
At a strip club.
Perfect. Do they have a paging system there?
Yeah, she has a pager.
She does?
Yeah.
All right, hold on a second. We'll see what we can do with her. Hold on there, Tobias. Hey, Danielle, let's see if we can find Tobias's girlfriend. She's working over at Frigid Girls, the strip club in Cincinnati for girls that don't perform oral sex. Boy, she could lose her license. They find out about this.
You know, it's not like it's a permit.
You know what I haven't done in a while, but I forgot the strip club DJ.
Oh, yeah.
I've been in a few strip clubs lately. Hill, I don't know if you get out to these things, but... Yeah, you
only research only.
Research. You know, it's like every single one of them, there's some sort of, at least, in California, Nevada, Seattle, when I've been all over the place and been to strip clubs, it's always the same guy. It's like, hey, ladies, show this camera. I was coming up the stage. Candy's coming up. She's coming up. Hey, show this camera. Be generous, sir. Catlin, up to the stage for show you care. I'm always like, do they really need these guys? I mean, you know what I'm saying? Just spin the goddamn record and shut the hell up. Play the Cherry Pie by Warren. Play all that good, bad 80s,
Poison.
You know, Poison and Motley Crue stuff and all the girls, girls, girls and all that. And then shut up. Yeah, boys, coming to the stage. We got Brittany now. You got Shortage Cash. You're moving up good. Hi, Chance. We're going to have a lap dance. $2 Fridays. $5 well drains. ATM in the hall. Don't forget, show me again. Lap dance. Would you shut up, you idiot? I'm trying to achieve an erection here. I can't do it with your inane ramblings. And
oh, damn it.
No one can understand a word you're saying, by the way.
Yeah, it's like humans talking to a dog. The dog's view of the human speech.
The dog understands more stripper,
more
nudie bar DJ than I do. I have no idea what these guys are ever talking about. They just got to. I'm gonna run a strip club where you just play classical music and there's no. And I have Tony Randall come in and speak to the gents.
That already exists. It's the White House.
Sam.
Yeah.
You're 28 years old.
Yeah.
Yeah. What's up?
I had this girlfriend from 2 years ago, and I performed oral sex with her.
Hang on a second, Sam. Sure. Sam is 28. Tobias was 18.
Yeah. Sam sounds younger than Tobias.
Yes, by a long shot.
That's right. Sam?
Yeah.
Sorry, keep going.
Oh, no problem. So, anyway, about a couple of years ago, I was with this one girl and performed oral sex with her. And it was the first time she's ever had it. And I don't know, I guess I was just average, just not going in. I mean, just I was...
A routine experience.
It was, yeah.
Okay, what's the question?
And the next day, she complained a lot about, well, she tells me it was really great, but then after that, she complained that she had an infection. Mm-hmm. And I was just wondering, like, because the mouth is just so full of all sorts of bacteria and stuff, I just was kind of hesitant to doing it again to anyone for a while. And then
No. Not unless you have chlamydia or gonorrhea in your mouth. Or herpes. Those are the only things that you really be likely to transmit from your mouth, which you can if you have those things. But if you don't, the usual mouth flora can just sort of upset the usual environment there and maybe trigger off a vaginitis, a yeast infection, or a bacterial infection.
That was a couple of years ago, Sam?
Yeah, about 2 years ago. But I mean, my hygiene's good. I mean, I brush my teeth twice a day, that sort of thing.
Yeah. So it was 2 years ago since you went down on a woman?
Yeah.
And you haven't gotten back on that horse again, huh?
I was hesitant to it for a while. And then now I'm with a woman, and I'm performing oral sex again.
Fantastic.
And I brought up this issue because I was just afraid of it happening again.
It's a real story of a triumph over a tragedy.
You're gay.
All right, Sam. You're fine.
Okay.
Everything's good.
You can trigger vaginal infections by just about anything. Okay? It's basically an overgrowth of the yeast or bacteria that are normally there. Okay?
Listen, you throw a stuffed animal at your woman's vagina, she'll get an infection. Do you understand?
Okay.
They're very prone to infection over there. Very, very difficult to figure out the vagina, right, Drew? George?
Yeah.
What's up?
What's up? What's going on?
You're 15.
Yeah. I had sex for the very first time last week.
Fantastic.
And I noticed like a little red spot, and I guess it kind of spread, and now they went away, but they're like, they almost look like pimples.
On your penis?
Yeah.
Yeah.
On the pants or on the pubic area?
No, on my head. I'm uncircumcised.
Where was the you didn't wear a condom, did you?
Stupidly, no.
All right. Who's the gal?
Huh? It's a girlfriend that I've been going out with her for a while.
Yeah. Was she a virgin, too?
Yeah.
Oh. All right. It doesn't sound too bad, but what do you think, Drew?
It just sounds like some sort of irritation. It doesn't sound like much of anything else. But these kinds of things need to be seen when there's something to see.
Uh-huh.
And once they've gone away, it's very hard to then sort of retrospect.
Did it go away, George?
No, not yet.
All right. Let a doctor look at it. It just sounds like some sort of dermatitis or irritation.
What?
Can be nothing. Sounds like nothing. Can
sounds
be
like
yeast. Can be a lot of little things. Kind of various kinds of irritation.
Did you go at it for a while?
I went at it for once, and then I kind of wanted to do it again, and so I went back again. And it was fine after that. And the next day, I like noticed just like a little spot. I was like,
all right. How long did you go at it the first time?
30
seconds?
5 minutes, maybe.
5 minutes?
Yeah, and then the second time I did about six.
6 minutes?
Yeah.
Uh-huh. And
why didn't you use a condom?
Well, I was stupid. Yeah. I hadn't,
stupid.
Gave my, my little fellow, you know.
How do you know it was 5 minutes and then 6 minutes?
Because I had a song playing.
Okay. Good.
Yeah.
All right, George. But listen, it's not musical chairs, you know? When the song ends, you don't have to finish.
Okay.
You understand? Sure that you care. Laughed at. Two for Fridays. Bring your buddies. We serve lunch. Business meeting. All right, George.
All right, thanks a lot.
All right. Every guy sounds exactly the same. I'm starting to think it's just a microphone they get. It's a certain strip club microphone.
No.
No. No, Anderson, no lightning round tonight.
Thank you.
I know. Oh, yeah, Anderson's saying the same thing. It's the lightning round.
Yeah, oh, yeah, it's the same voice, same person.
Same guy.
They tired him off the radio.
Hey, you know why the guys are so excited? Because they're working at a nudie bar. They're getting paid. They're playing records, and chicks are dancing around naked, and they're banging half of them because they always drive them home. And was, you know, it's, so it's like, hey, you're new, huh, Tammy? It's Tammy. Is that your real name? Oh, yeah. Okay. You want to do some coke in the parking lot? I'll give you a ride home. You know, these guys, these strippers, they seem like super women, but the reality is the club closes down, all the guys leave, and then it's just 25 chicks all standing around in sweatpants ready to go back to, their one-bedroom apartments with no boyfriends around. These guys got themselves a, new El Camino, going to drive the chick home. Yeah, I'll keep an eye on you. Yeah. Oh, that's a good gig. All right, we'll take ourselves a little break. We'll be back after this.
Back once again with it.
Love Line. Savannah Carolla and Dr. Drew will be right back before you know it.
The This is Loveline on Outrageous Talk Radio, 100.7 The Buzz.
Yep. All right, it is Loveline. I'm Adam, that's Drew. Hill Harper's our guest tonight. You can find him on City of Angels, CBS, Wednesday nights, 8 o'clock. Also, you'll see him coming up on the big screen in The Skulls, which is the 31st of March. And if you want to go by the video store and rent Pumpkinhead 2, you might find us. You might find him acting in that. All right. Erica?
Yeah.
You're 19 years old. What's up?
Yeah, last night I lost my virginity, and
yeah.
I don't know how to feel about it. I feel...
You don't sound too happy.
No.
Was it something you were planning not to lose until marriage or something?
Yeah.
Erica, you're 19. You sound like you're 11. Oh, that's a good answer.
Was this something forced on you?
No. It was, we had a lot of drink.
It's just so interesting talking to... We just talked to a male who just lost his virginity at 15. He was like, he's on top of it. Women at 19. Oh, mistake. Mistake.
Yeah.
And that's the way it always goes.
Well, he had 5 minutes and then 6 minutes. You know, it's funny, though, with guys. 5 minutes, and then the next one is 6 minutes, and then it drops. 4 hours and 22 minutes. I mean, that third one's a bitch. It's not 5 minutes, 6 minutes, and 7 minutes. It's 5 minutes, 6 minutes, 3.5 hours.
2 days.
2 days. All right, Erica, why is it that you sound like you're 11 when you're 19?
Well, I was abused a lot.
Oh, okay.
In what way? Physically abused?
About everything.
Really?
Well, how could you be a virgin?
Well, not sexually abused. I've been verbally, mentally, and physically. And
all right, well, there it goes.
Some sexual abuse? Some sexual abuse?
Yeah, no sexual abuse. Just
no sexual abuse.
Still be careful that sex doesn't become a way of acting out.
I don't know. 19. I don't think so.
Yeah, but now they kind of turn on here.
We've released the hounds?
Yeah. Especially if she's ashamed and angry and upset about this.
Do you have a boyfriend, Erica?
No.
Yeah, that's what you mean.
No. Who was this guy?
I met him last weekend, and we saw each other again this weekend, and I don't know where we stand with each other, and I want to ask him, but...
Ask him what?
Know how to ask him, like, where we stand within a relationship, or was it just like...
Boy. But of course...
Erica, what are you doing now with your life?
I'm screwing up, sorry.
Oh, okay. Hey, Erica.
Yeah.
You living at home?
Yeah.
And your mom around?
Yeah, she around.
Is she okay?
Huh?
Is she all right?
Yeah.
Where's the abusive guys?
I've been abused from doctors to my grandparents and teachers and...
Oh, boy. And where's your dad?
He lives in Orange County.
Did he start the abuse?
No.
Teachers abused you?
Huh?
Did you say teachers abused you?
Yeah. My teacher in second grade abused me.
And what did they do?
She just, slapped me.
Slapped you.
Now, listen, you think that's bad. Mr. Gregory failed me out of driver's ed. 15 and a half. You know what kind of summer that was for me at 16? No license? Driver's ed. Failed driver's ed. Not driver's training. Driver's ed. Do you know what it takes to fail driver's ed? You have to commandeer one of the two-wheeled, steering-wheeled cars and drive it through the classroom. That's the only way you can
and out the window.
Fail driver's ed. And then go out the window like the Blues Brothers. Jesus Christ.
And a doctor abused you? What happened with that?
It's not really clear, but he just, when I was about in third grade, when I got a physical or something, I can't remember what it was for, but he just touched me and...
Hold on a second there, Erica. Let me talk to my partners, Hill and Drew. Starting to get the feeling Erica's maybe Erica wasn't touched as much as she thought.
She interprets everything as that.
Maybe something's up with her mind a little bit.
Well, but that's part of, you know, a victim's a victim, and some part of that role is making everybody a victimizer.
Right.
Not actually finding the victimizer, but if you can't, casting them in that role, even if they're not that.
Right. All right. All right. Well, Erica, use protection. Don't get pregnant. Stay in school. Or if you're not in school, go get in school. Move out of the house.
Get a boyfriend. Get a real person to be in a relationship.
Start reading. Go on long walks. Exercise. Eat 15 servings of
tofu.
Leafy vegetables every day. You ever see those charts where they tell you how much of whatever you should be doing?
Yeah.
And it's like... Well, you should drink 15 gallons of spring water every day. Like, does coffee count? No. What about soda? No. Christ. And then 140 servings of green leafy vegetable. How about like a corn dog? Would that count? The corn? No. And what'll happen if I don't do it? You'll collapse. Diabetic coma. And you're like, I haven't done any of that ever in my life. And they're like, I feel fine. What are they talking about, Drew, with all that nonsense? Eat, you know, 15 servings of fruit and vegetable. Now, does anyone do that?
Yeah.
Nobody does that.
Yeah.
No one drinks, you know, 4 quarts of water every day. Nobody does any of that. Everyone's fine. The hell are they talking about?
Hey, remind me about corn dogs. I was at Disneyland over the weekend, and they have corn dogs. They're the size of, like your arm.
Rhino corn dogs, they call them.
And I was going to say, have you seen what they're doing down there?
At Disneyland?
Oh, my God.
What are they doing?
They're building a monstrosity, this new theme park.
Drew, you're in way over your head with those kids.
Oh, yeah.
Drew takes his kids. Drew is so whipped by his kids. It's not enough that he takes them to Disneyland every other weekend, but they stay there.
Yeah, we stay at Disneyland Hotel.
They stay at the Disneyland.
Great.
Oh, those kids. Oh,
spoiled.
They're going to be ruined.
Spoiled.
No, ruined.
They take good care of us there, too.
Drew, they better be sending some women over because there's not. Please, every other weekend you're with those kids in the hotel. You know, realize I went to Disneyland once every 9 years, and my dad wouldn't even let me look at the hotel. He didn't want me to get any ideas. Just keep walking. Look at your feet and keep walking, son. That's what he'd yell. I'd say, what's that? The matter? Look down. Don't you eyeball that Matterhorn, son. You keep walking straight. What's that? Is that the hotel over there? That's a maximum security prison. You want to go in there? Be beaten and sodomized and take your shoes from you. All right, just keep walking, son. I used to go to Disneyland during the day when they had the E-ticket, R ticket, the F ticket, and all that stuff.
Yeah.
You'd use that E-ticket once on the Matterhorn, and then you're effed for the rest of the day.
Yeah.
You got to go to Pirates of the Caribbean.
You got like an E-ticket. You got like 2 E-tickets in the packet. You get to go on the Matterhorn, the Pirates of the Caribbean. I'd shoot my wad in the first 20 minutes.
Yeah.
It was like 14 hours of watching my sister on the teacups after that.
Or riding the fire engine down Main Street.
Yeah. All right, I've done more laps around this than Richard Petty's done around Talladega in this goddamn fire engine. I'm begging to leave at it now. All right, Tamara?
Yes?
You're 19.
Yes.
What's up?
Well, I've been with this guy for almost going on 9 months now, and he keeps on insisting to have anal sex with me, and I keep telling him no because we did it once before and it hurt.
Ouch!
All right, well, that's enough. Fine.
Yeah, that's it.
If he keeps going, you cut him off.
Yeah, cut him off generally, you understand?
Yeah.
Just say, this is getting so uncomfortable for me, there'll be no sex, period.
Go ahead, lay the law down.
The women got to understand they are in control. They're in the driver's seat.
That's right.
Go right ahead.
Yep. You want to pull the car over? Go pull it over. Pull it right to the shoulder. He'll be masturbating by one of those call boxes. All right, Tamara?
Okay.
You did it once. You didn't like it. You fulfilled your duty. Or actually, he filled your duty. Thank you. All right, there. Drew, where are we going here?
I think we're going to break.
Thank you. Thank you very much. All right, real quick. Jason?
Yeah?
You've been on hold for 96 minutes.
Yeah.
All right, you have 15 seconds. You ready? Go.
Okay, I've been, like, depressed lately.
Uh-huh.
And I've started smoking pot, and I've just felt, like crap about myself.
Did your grades drop off, too?
In a way, I've stopped doing my homework.
Jason, you got to get, this is the classic signs of a depression in your age. You need to get that treated. You're going to screw up if you don't get it treated. Okay, seriously, you got to talk to your doctor, your parents, your school teacher, somebody about how you're feeling. This is totally treatable, and it's important to treat it because you're going to fall right in your face if you don't and screw up things that could put you in a bad position moving forward in your life.
All right.
How would I go about getting
to talk? Help? Can you talk to your school? Talk to your parents. Tell them you don't tell them about the pot. Just tell them you're feeling kind of bad.
Parents, teachers, counselor at school, regular doctor, whoever it is, tell an adult who's in a position to help you.
It happened to me in high school. They talked to my parents. I'd been getting F's and F's, and then I got depressed. I was getting F's, F's, and F's. And that's when the red light went off. My parents knew there was trouble. Yeah, I'd been getting D's, F's, D's and F's and F's, and then I was getting D's and F's and F's and F's. Mm. And that's when they snapped an act.
You got F and F's.
I got F and F's. We'll take a break.
Let's have some more fun.
Okay, let's do it. Call LoveLine, 1-800-LOVE-191.
LoveLine, we'll be right back.
Well, here's how it's sampled.
Well, now.
This has been LoveLine. The stuff expressed on LoveLine is not necessarily the stuff of the staff, management, sponsors, or anyone else, including Westwood One Entertainment. LoveLine is produced by Ann Wilkins Ingold. Now, please enjoy these birds.